when we are talking about the struggle of land, in the 1970s, when the nationalized movement first started, what was the demand? The demand was land to the tiller. The demand was justice. The demand was, give us what you have, but which is our right. Today, the demand is only, please let us hold on to what little we have. You know, we've even lost our dreams. We have even lost the nerve to say we believe in equality. You know, when the most radical politics is located in the struggle against displacement, it means that we have forgotten about those who have been displaced, and we have forgotten about those who never had any land in the first place. You know, today, between 70 and 90% of Dalits don't have land. You know, so they are not in the radical struggles, because we look at it as a struggle for land. And, you know, we were all in the city when there was the protest about the Delhi gang rape. That same year, more than 1,600 Dalit women were raped by upper caste men. So, I think, you know, the other thing is, we must be careful not to portray the people in our struggles always as victims. You know, neither the women nor the Adivasis. Now, where do we find, I remember early in the studio when we went to Kerala, when the struggle was at its peak and it was very strong, and they had refused to hoist a national flag on Independence Day, and they had hoisted a black flag. And all the villagers were, you know, so strong. And we were walking through the village, and suddenly I noticed a beautiful thing. There was a man, very beautiful man, who was dressed as a woman. And that same day, two girls got married to each other in that village. And these are such beautiful things which are to be celebrated in our films and in our thinking of resistance. You know, it's not only against the corporations or against the state, but, you know, as a, perhaps after 15 or 17 years of writing the things that I've written, I feel perhaps even because, you know, I've become so well known, I resent the idea that I'm always supposed to make the policy statement when I write. You know, it's like I have to say, you know, this or that, or free speech, or, you know, I want the right to write about the really small, stubborn resistances too. And not only resistances, also to explore our own cruelty, our own, and I think only then tabhi hum log ye jo bada bada sanskriti ka jo aakraman hai tabhi hum log uska jawab de sakenge jab hum apne aap ko limit nahi karte hain jab hum ek pura naya universe banate apna kala se. सिर्फ ये नहीं कि रेजिस्टेंस या स्टेट या कोऑपरेशन या कहीं ना कहीं कोई झंडा उगाड़ देते हम, लेकिन हमेशा झंडा होने का जरूरत नहीं है, कभी बिना झंडे का काम और भी सबवर्सिव होता है. तो सिर्फ मैं पता नहीं शायद थोड़ा अपना दिल की बात रख दिया, क्योंकि मैं एक्चुअली असली में कहना चाहती हूँ, मैं दो हफ्ते के बाद कहूँगी, मैं गोरखपुर में आती हूँ. थैंक यू.